It was all a dream on the scene, making memes.
Then I came along and changed everything.
From ciphers to diapers.
Green jiggly things.
But the grind don't stop.
We just got a bigger team.
Hard to wait to the top.
Mom, what does that mean?
The time is now or never.
We are Dream Team. I was gonna get paid for this.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Lyric Kane, aka Nini, aka whatever it is that you want to call me, back with yet another reaction video. As requested in the comment section underneath one of my other videos, today I have the honors of reacting to AMB Grindin, the official music. Apparently, I can't talk today. The official music video, in the parentheses, it says Axe Murder Boyz. I'm guessing that's what AMB stands for. Twiztid presents Year of the Sword. My boy's Twiztid. But you already know the original video link will be in the description box down below, as well as all of our social media links. Please make sure that you follow us on IG and Facebook, Best Friends Since Birth. Also, check out my music page on IG, Lyric Kane Official. Also in the description box down below, you'll be able to find my other YouTube channel. Make sure you head over there and check out my music. If you like what you hear, go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe, turn on notifications so that you don't miss out on all of my latest music videos, original songs, cover songs, remakes, remixes, challenges, and live performances. And without further ado, we're going to go right ahead and we're going to get right into the video. Okay. Loving his flow already. He kind of got like a little Snoop Dogg feel to him. Okay. Almost like a little Bone Thugs and Harmony to his flow, like the way he hit those when he does that double time. Okay. I should have known though. I love his flow, y'all. Come on. Come on. Hey, you can tell the way he grew it. He into it, though. Okay. Hey, I want to see this live. I feel like the crowd would just go crazy when this chorus hit. Just everybody just like hitting it. And that bass drop. His braid little look reminds me of Crisscross. If y'all don't know who that is, y'all sleep. But that right there was definitely dope. I was not prepared for that, like, at all. Now, the crazy thing is, I want to say I've heard quite a bit. Oh, no. What the hell did I just do? I've heard quite a bit of horrorcore music or music by M&E and by Psychopathic Records. And most of it is like music. I'm just like, okay, this right here was cool, like that bangs. But I don't think other than Lex the Hex Masters, I've ever heard anything that I would be like, necessarily be like, oh, I would bang that in my car. But on my mama, I'm gonna go download that song and bang that in my car, because that's how, like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, the energy, like, the vibes. Like, certain songs just, like, feed you vibes. And that song was feeding me vibes. And I'm about to Google it because I need to know these men's names so that I can put some respect on it. You know what I mean? After you hear a record like that, you need to at least enjoy these men by their names. So, okay, let's see what Wikipedia has for us. Where's my glasses? James and Mike Garcia are brothers of Spanish descent in Mexican America. And you know what? I heard him mention a couple of Hispanic words. I heard him mention a couple of I heard him say a couple of Spanish words, like Dios los muertes, which I feel like everybody knows about that. And he said another word that I can't think of right now, referring to like what the chicks call him. But it never hit me like they could be, I thought they were white boys. Apparently not. That was dope, though. That was dope. And I feel like Wikipedia is lying to me now, so I'm just gonna click out of it. But that right there was definitely dope. Like, seriously, like I said, I've heard quite a bit through you guys, through the Juggalo and the Juggalette community. And although, like I always say, like, you guys are so open and allowing me to, like, come and experience this. It's not necessarily what I would listen to on my own without you guys making that request. It's not something that I would normally listen to. But I think, like I said, other than Lex the Hex Master, because he has some songs on his last little track, his ass, a little, I think I said his ass, his last album, where I was just like, bruh, he was giving me, like, Beanie Siegel vibes, which I rocks with Beanie, so now I rocks with Lex. But, that right there would definitely be something I'm gonna go have to download and go, like, bump in my car, because that shit, like, that definitely goes. That was dope, though. I love that flow. I love their style, their demeanor, like, the way they carried themselves, their delivery, just, like, I feel like I'm repeating myself, but, like, that was just lovable. Like, that shit was fucking lovable. Like, who couldn't love that? Get in the comments down below and let me know what you thought. Were you digging it or were you not? If so, tell me why. If not, tell me why. Don't be no hater, though. Yeah, let's talk about it. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe, turn on notifications so that you don't miss out. Till next time, guys. Peace out. I'm out of here.